This is the palatine bone. Generally, it is L-shaped, like a capital L, and it has a horizontal plate and a perpendicular plate. The horizontal plate of the palatine bone forms part of the heart palate, and the vertical plate here forms part of the lateral wall of the nose. So here below the horizontal plate is the mouth, and above the horizontal plate is the nose, and the perpendicular plate forms part of the lateral wall of the nose. This foramen is the sphenopalatine foramen. It transmits the nasopalatine nerve and sphenopalatine vessels coming from the pterygopalatine fossa. This is the region of the pterygopalatine fossa, which is located lateral to the nose. And this small piece of bone, this plate of bone here, this is the orbital plate of the palatine bone that participate in the formation of the floor of the orbit. As you can see here, that the bone is grooved and canalized by the greater and lesser palatine nerves as they reach the heart palate. Groove for the greater and lesser palatine nerves. This is again to show you the palatine bone in its position. So this is the horizontal plate of the palatine bone, and these are the grooves and canals that transmit the greater and lesser palatine vessels. And you can see that the palatine bone also participate in the formation of the lateral wall of the nose. This is the posterior nasal aperture, the nasal septum here formed by the vomer. And this is in the lateral wall of the nose is the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone, and there is a foramen here, which is the sphenopalatine foramen. And in the orbit, you can see this small piece of brown bone, and this is the orbital plate of the palatine bone. It participates in the formation of the floor of the orbit.